Alright guys, and I'm back. Sorry, I just thought that'd be a good place to stop because I was getting close to my time and I figured, well, why not now? So, alright, yes, as you can see, I kind of cleaned that up back there because I noticed it looked like shit. Now let's talk about his weapon. It's a spring-loaded missile. There's not much to say. It's a spring-loaded missile. We've seen them all before, and we hate them. Well, most people do. I really wish they had done more of, like, the War Machine, comic book War Machine, or just the comic book series in general, because they all have stuff like this, where it attacks instead of the missile, because that is much cooler, in my opinion, to pose them with that instead of these big oversized gun that doesn't belong. Especially in this aesthetic, this nice, clean, slick aesthetic, and then you have this big gawking gun with a missile. Not good. Not good at all. Anyways, let's go over articulation. Hopefully this time I won't break him. So arm, full 360 degree rotation. Actually, first thing I should say is, this guy, unlike the other Iron Man marks, except for Mark 5 and Mark 4, I believe, because the Mark 4 has the same shoulder pads, they are a soft rubbery plastic, and I love that, because you know what? Know what you can actually do with this guy? Oh my god, it's a repulsor blast. And his head's at a horrible angle, but it's a repulsor blast, and you can actually do it with this figure. It's amazing! Hasbro finally got the idea! Now, if only they gave you replaceable hands, so you could do more than the Vangelist, I'ma punch my hand with my fist and be erg, give me my money, wench, rar. So yeah, I wish you could get some other hands, but what are you gonna do? So yes, like you said, full 360 rotation, you can go up, can you go down, full swivel at the elbow, and one point of articulation, and the hand rotates. Now, one thing that it makes me hopeful, and I guess the reason why I need to get some of the other marks of the Iron Man armor, his hand comes off. So you can do, so you know, you got a Mega Buster kind of thing, which is kind of cool. But the reason why I really enjoy that is because, hold on, is because that means you might be able to swap hands, which means you can get an Iron Man in a repulsor blast pose, which would be awesome. Because, you know, you get the legs out and kind of, you know, up there. I'm not going to bother really doing it, but I want to have, you know, two fists and one on each side, and then a repulsor blast pose, which would be nice, but the only current figure that has at least two semi-similar looking hands is my Power Assault, is the Power Assault armor, and those are open fists, those are open hands, so not exactly what I want. Anyways, head is on a ball joint, and can pop off. And you got a a pretty loose joint in there. But it stays where it needs to stay. It's loose but tight at the same time. That's weird, but whatever. It is. It's just right. Leg has the Hasbro legs or the Hasbro hips, so you know, you can do all sorts of stuff that you don't want to do with these things. But the one nice thing is, he can have his legs closed. Which means, if I could get another hand that's, you know, open like this, you could get a really good flying pose, except his head doesn't, you know, really work, but whatever. Yeah, so you got the hips, and you also have the knee. Two points of articulation, and the scoop that you kill a grandma when you go swipe. The flying knee kick! Whoosh. Knee raise. Why do I keep saying knee kick? Whatcha! So, you know, you can go flying across. I'ma kill ya. And you have articulation in the foot. Now, back here is, once again, another rubbery plastic kind of plastic. What a surprise! So you can get a large degree of, posing in there. But I wouldn't recommend doing that because it's already starting to, just from that short time it was staying out there long and you don't want that. But yes, overall, nice figure. Almost forgot. We got the stand, the bland stand. I'm going to officially call them that. And the cards. Now I wish it didn't have that gawky gun on there, but I'm hoping that I can find a good... this is better. So now he's got the powered assault armors, arm cannons, which aren't bad looking, but I don't like that that's on there, because it really... it doesn't need to be in. As far as I know, none of the other... let me just look quick. Yeah, none of the other armors have their big guns on there, so... I don't know why he did, why he needed it. So in closing, I say get this guy. He does everything you want him to do, and you have to check for a QC on these guys, because for some reason, the actual Iron Man toys have the problem. I don't know why they're having these issues. The feel of this guy, the aesthetic, the... whole having his chest, you can see that it has, he bends his back up. Otherwise, if you had him like this, he just kind of is looking down at the ground. So, you have to bend his back up a little bit, but he looks like Iron Man. And he does a repulsor blast, so come on, guys, pick this guy up. If that's not a sound endorsement, I don't know what is. So, this is the Autobot. And Iron Man Mark 6 here, signing off, reminding you all, until that day, till all are one.